Hello everyone, today we will see the case 2 to find the actual stress in the concrete and the steel of singly reinforced beam. So in this case, the data is given, width of the section, effective depth, area of steel and modular ratio and moment. Moment is given. So width of the section, depth of the effective depth, area of steel, modular ratio, and the moment of resistance is given. And out of which we have to identify the actual stresses in the steel and the concrete. So stresses in the steel and concrete is sigma CBC and sigma SC. Okay. So very first step in this is to find the actual neutral axis by the equation D into F into X by 2 into modular ratio into area of steel into D minus X. Okay. So where B is given, modular ratio is given, area of steel is given, and effective depth is given. So only unknown is this one, X one. Okay, so we have to find out this X. Okay. And after this, we have to find lever arm that is dead. So lever arm is can be calculated by the equation D minus X by 3. So by calculating this step number 2, we can calculate the value of sigma ST by this equation, moment of resistance equals to T into Z. Okay. So from this equation, area of steel is given and Z we have calculated. So only sigma ST is unknown to us. Okay. So from this equation, we can identify the value of sigma ST. Then from this equation, the next step is to find the stress in the concrete, that we have to calculate the sigma CBC. So in this equation, sigma CBC by sigma ST by M equals to X by D minus X. So in this equation, the value of X, the value of D and sigma ST and M, this value we know, only unknown is sigma CBC. So from this, we can calculate the sigma CBC. So this is the step of case number 2. So there are 4 steps in case number 2. In which first one is to find the neutral axis, to find the lever arm by putting the equation of moment M equals to T into Z, we can calculate value of sigma ST and then sigma CBC. Okay, so let's see the example on this. Is that clear to you? Shall I proceed? Is that clear to you? Shall I proceed? Okay, we will end up this class immediately at 11 because there is a parent teacher meet after that. So in the example, it is given as a section RC beam 300 the RC beam having the section of 300 by 700 mm is reinforced with 4 bars of 25 mm bar, placed 30 mm from the bottom of the beam. The beam is subjected to the bending moment of 130 kN. This bending moment is nothing but the moment or the moment of resistance. Find stresses in the concrete and steel. Modular ratio is given 18.60. So as per the procedure which we have seen in the case 2, all the data is given as the width is given 300 mm, effective depth is given as this is the overall depth 700 mm. This 700 mm minus 30 mm is the effective cover, that is 700 minus 30, we are getting the effective depth as 670 mm. Now moment is given 130 kN. We have to convert this kN into the newton mm because all the value we are taking in newton and mm. So this kilonewton into meter, we will convert this by multiplying 10 raised to the power 6. Okay, so the value becomes 130 into 10 raised to the power 6 newton mm. Now the modular ratio is 18.66. Area of steel is given as 4 bars of 25 mm diameter. So it is 4 into pi by 4 into 25 square. So the value of area of steel we are getting 1964 mm square. Okay. So from the first step, we have to calculate value of x. So to find the value of x, b into x by 2 equals to m area of steel into d minus x is the formula for this, and in which only the value of x is unknown to us. So it becomes 300 into x square by 2 equals to 18.66 into 1964 into 670 minus x. So from this equation we can calculate the value of x, and it is found 300 mm. Okay. Now second step is to find the value of lever arm, that is the value of z. Okay, so z is given as d minus x by 3. So d, the value of d is 670, value of x is 300 by 3, so we are getting the value of z is 570 mm. Okay, so after getting these two values, we can calculate the value of sigma xt. So moment of resistance equals to t into z. From this equation, only the value of sigma xt is unknown to us. Okay, so moment of resistance is given 130 into 10 raised to 6, area of 64, value of sigma cst is unknown, and the value of z is we have calculated as 570. So from this equation we can calculate the value of sigma xt, that is 160 newton per mm square. Okay, now the last one, that is to calculate the value of sigma cvc. So sigma cvc, from this equation, sigma cvc by sigma xt equals to x divided by d minus x. So in which equation only sigma cvc is unknown to us, sigma xt we have recently calculated as 160. So put all this value and calculate the sigma cvc, we will find the value of sigma cvc as 5 newton per mm. So is that clear to you? Please reply fast. Is that clear to you? Okay. Now get the screenshot of this example number 2. We will proceed for example number 2. The section is given 350 by 650 overall. Is provided with tensile reinforcement consisting of 420 mm fly bar. Calculate the stress developed in steel and concrete if the beam carries a UDL of 20 kN per meter, including of steel plate. Take effective length 7 meter. Modular ratio is given 13.33, and the cover is given 25 mm. So from this data, the width of the section is given 350. Effective depth is given. So effective depth is overall depth minus effective cover. Okay, so overall depth is 650, effective cover is 25. So 650 minus 25, we are getting effective depth is 625 mm. Okay, now the modular ratio is given 13.33. Weight, that is uniformly distributed load over the section, is given 20 kN per meter. From this load we can calculate the moment of resistance. Okay, because we know the UDL is subjected to that particular section, and the length of effective length of that section is also given. So from this we can calculate the moment. Okay, the moment is also given in this numerical. Effective length is given 7 meter, and area of steel is given as 4 into pi by 4 into 22 square. We are getting the value of area of steel as 1520 mm square. Okay, so from very first step we have to find the value of x. So value of x we can identify, we can determine by the equation d into x by 2 equals to m area steel into d minus x. So from this equation only value of x is unknown. Okay, so if you calculate this value, then we found the value of x is 217 mm. Okay, now the next step is to find the lever arm, that is d minus x by 3, and we are getting this as 552.66 mm. Okay, so by the time you keep the calculator with you, and you can calculate all this value whether it is right or wrong. Okay, and let me know if there is a correction. Okay, now move towards the point C, that is MR into T into Z. So the equation is the area of steel into sigma ST into lever arm, that is 552.66. So before calculating this, you must know about the moment of resistance, which is not given in the numerical directly. So we have to calculate it by the equation WL square by 8 as the load is in UDL. Okay. So 20 into 7 square divided by 8, we are getting the value of modular ratio 122.5 kilonewton meter, and we have converted it in newton mm by multiplying 10 raised to the power 6. Okay. So this value we are getting. Now we have to equate this M with MR, and the equation will become 122.5 into 10 raised to 6 equals to 1520 into sigma ST into 552.66. So only sigma ST is unknown to us in this equation. So we will find the value of sigma ST as 145.82 newton per mm square. Okay. Now the last one is to find the sigma CBC. So sigma CBC is sigma CBC divided by sigma ST by M equals to X minus D minus X. So putting the value of X, D, M and sigma ST in this equation, we will get the value of sigma CBC as 5.818 newton per mm square. So this is the way to determine the stresses in the steel and the concrete in the section. Okay. So the value of D is 625. We have calculated in the given data itself. Okay. Overall depth of the section is given as 650, and we have deduct the value of clear effective cover, that is given 25 mm. So effective depth we are getting as 625 mm. Okay. Is that clear, Mr. Suraj? Is that clear? So now you can take the screenshot of the example number 2 of case number 2. Okay. If you are done with the screenshot, we will stop here. Okay.